My dear brothers and sisters, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, He knows we have weakness. He Himself said in the Quran, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. Human being is created as weak. He knows that how much we do commit sin every day and night, and we're worried. Those who are worried about their sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Say, O my servants, who have transgressed against themselves by sinning, do not despair of Allah's mercy, the mercy of Allah. Indeed, Allah forgives all sins. Indeed, it is He who is the forgiving, the merciful. So this is, many of the scholars say, this the ayah, arja al-ayah fil Quran, giving us most hope in Allah's mercy. That He said He can forgive all sins. So it's the most hopeful verse in the Quran. So this is giving us a good thought about Allah. And having good thought about Allah is a very good, itself is very good ibadah. That Allah will forgive me. Allah will not destroy me. Allah will not, you know, leave me. He will rescue me. These hope are very good thought about Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciate that. Only Allah says, you try your best. وَاسْتَعِينُ بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ الَّذِينَ يَذُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُ رَبِّهِمْ وَأَنَّهُمْ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. And seek health through patience and prayer, salah. And indeed, it is difficult to have, you know, to pray on time, to have, you know, hold the salah. And sabr, patience, is not so easy, it's difficult. Indeed, it is difficult except for the humbly submissive to Allah. If we try to submit to Allah, Allah will help us. Those who are submissive to Allah, they always have a hope and believe, and they are certain that they will meet their Lord one day and that they will return to Him. So those having this dhan also has meaning of yaqeen, hope also there in terms of the with the certainty they believe and hope in Allah's mercy. When they meet Him, He will be kind to them. And another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمُقْرَأُوا كِتَابِيَ إِنِّي ظَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقٍ حِسَابِيَ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ فِي جَنَّةٍ عَالِيَةٍ قُتُوفُهَا دَانِيَةٍ. So as for he who is given his record in his right hand, he will say, here, read my record. He'll call his friends, family members, see, this is my record given to me in right hand. Indeed, I was certain and hopeful and having good thought about Allah that I would be meeting my account. I was hoping that Allah will show mercy upon me. He'll be giving me in right hand. That's why, so he'll be in a pleasant life in an elevated garden in Jannah. It is fruit to be picked hanging near that all this ni'mah because he was having this good hope in Allah's mercy. Having this a good thought about Allah itself is very appreciated. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna husna dhanni billahi ta'ala min husni al-ibada." If somebody is having a good thought about Allah, that Allah will be forgiving me, Allah will be merciful towards me, Allah will rescue me, all this good hope and good thought about Allah itself is a good ibadah. Itself is a good ibadah. We should not be despair of Allah's mercy and His favor. In a hadith, Jabir radiallahu anhu narrates, قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قبل موته بثلاثة أيام يقول لا يموتن أحدكم إلا وهو يحسن الظن بالله عز وجل. That's 3 days before death. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, none of you should die except he is having a good thought about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially before death. And this advice is given, this good news is given by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam just 3 days after, before his death. So it's good news for this ummah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive those who will have good thought about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another hadith he said, أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنِّ عَبْدِي بِي I am according to my servant thought about me. وَأَمَّاهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي So he is according to our thought about him. If we think he is merciful, he will forgive me, alhamdulillah, then Allah is going to forgive us. If we think, I don't think I have any hope in Allah's mercy, na'udhu billah, then you don't deserve Allah's mercy. So this is the hope. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي I am with him when he remembers me. فَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِهِ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِي When he remembers me within himself, personally, I do that within myself about him, privately. Me and him, I remember him. I think about him. وَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ ذَكَرْتُ فِي مَلَئٍ خَيْرٍ مِّنْهُمْ When he remembers me in a gathering, I remember him a gathering which is better than his gathering. And gathering of Allah is a malaikatuhu al-muqarrabun. The angels who are very close to him. وَإِنْ تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ شِبْرًا تَقَرَّبْتِ إِلَيْهِ ذِرَاعًا He comes to me one span, I go towards him, a ذِرَاعًا in full hand, one yard. وَإِنْ تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتِ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا If he comes to to me one hand, I go to him one yard towards him, double of his speed. وَإِنْ أَتَانِي يَمْشِي أَتَيْتُهُ هَرْوَلَةً He comes, if he walking to me, I go to run to him to rescue him. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's more keen than us to forgive us. Does he need a positive attitude from us? He's giving us more good news in many of the hadith Qudsi. He said, another hadith Qudsi, O son of Adam, Ya ibn Adam, innaka ma da'awtani wa rajawtani ghafartu laka ala ma kana minka wa la ubali. Ya ibn Adam, la balagat عنان ذنوبك عنان السماء ثم استغفرتني غفرت لك يا ابن آدم إنك لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا ثم لقيتني لا تشرك به شيئا لا أتيتك بقرابها مغفرة الله سبحانه وتعالى said O son of Adam I forgive you as long as you pray to me and hope for my forgiveness whatever sins you have committed O son of Adam I do not care If your sins reach the height of the heaven, then you ask for my forgiveness, I would forgive you. O son of Adam, if you come to me with an earth load of sins and meet me associating nothing to me, I would match it with an earth load of forgiveness. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kind and merciful, giving us all these good news. Another hadith he said in Hadith Qudsi again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, a slave committed a sin. أَذْنَبَ عَبْدِ ذَنْبًا فَقَالَ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِي فَقَالَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى أَذْنَبَ عَبْدِ ذَنْبًا فَعَلِمَ أَنَّ لَهُ رَبًّا يَغْفِرُ الذَّنْبِ وَيَأْخُذُ بِالذَّنْبِ ثُمَّ عَادَ فَأَذْنَبَ فَقَالَ أَيْ رَبْ اغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِي فَقَالَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى أَذْنَبَ عَبْدِ ذَنْبًا فَعَلِمَ أَنَّ لَهُ رَبًّا يَغْفِرُ الذَّنْبِ وَيَأْخُذُ بِالذَّنْبِ ثُمَّ عَادَ فَأَذْنَبَ فَقَالَ أَيْ رَبْ اغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِي فَقَالَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى He repeats and in the end he said قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لِعَبْدِي فَلْيَفْعَلْ مَا شَاءَ Another riwaya فَلْيَفْعَلْ مَا شَاءَ Again and again مَا دَامَ يَفْعَلُ هَكَذَا I will be forgiving him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this hadith My slave committed a sin then he realized that he has a Rabb a master the one who can forgive who forgives the sins and punish for the sin. He can do both. He then again, so I forgive him. Then he commits sin again and say, Oh Rabb, I have committed sin. Then again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, my slave committed a sin. Then he realized that he had a Rabb, and he is asking him to forgiveness. I am forgiving him again. Then he said again, he does go to commit the sin again, and he realized he has committed sin again, third time, and maybe again and again. And he comes to Allah, he realizes immediately after sin, he has committed sin. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives him. He said, I have granted forgiveness to my slave. Let him do whatever he likes. So this is not the license that we can do sin. No worry, Allah is there to forgive us. That is not the license he's giving to us. What he's giving us is that he knows we have created with this weakness. We do tawbah, again we commit the sin, but it should not be despair of his mercy, and should still carry having the good thought about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we try to do tawbah. These ahadiths mention the issue of tawbah again. And another hadith mentions the shirk. So the two things here mentioned, if somebody is committed sin, but he doesn't commit shirk, even the committed shirk, he does tawbah, may Allah forgive as well. So the tawbah is needed. Again and again, we try our best, but we never be hopeless of Allah's mercy, despair of Allah's mercy. I just remember a story. A day ago, a young man came. I'm not going to his name to identify him. Just remember him. He was 8 or 9 years old, young man. Now he's teenager, probably 16, 17. He's very worried. When he was 8 and 9 years old, he has killed a kitten. Killed it. A young man didn't think that seriously. Now he is so worried, so worried. And the remorse and regret in him. Then I tell him something of around this ahadith. So there is no reason that we will be just regretting and being hopeless and despair of Allah's mercy. And so much in depression of that. Many times shaitan will come to use this positive attitude, you regret, you remorse, you like to, you know, correct yourself. But the shaitan will come, no, you have committed so much sin, there is no hopeless, you know, left for you. This is shaitan's strategy. First, he wanted to give us wasasa to commit the sin and again, and then he is coming to make us hopeless from Allah's mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us all this good news. Let us, brothers and sisters, we do understand this generosity of Allah, appreciate, and we come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time we commit sin, let us do sincere tawbah, and this is the process. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will correct us, will purify us, inshallah, so he will be accepting our tawbah, and giving us tawfiq of tawbah nasiha, nasuha, awillahi tawfiq. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا واتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.